Hello dear students, I am Arshianas. In today's video, let us continue 6th chapter Constructions, exercise 6.2 from Karnataka State Mathematics text. In our previous videos, we have solved 4 problems from this exercise. Now let us move on to 5th problem. Let us read the question and understand each and every point in this. Okay, let us start. Draw a line segment AB of length 8 cm. Taking A as center, draw a circle of radius 4 cm. And taking B as center, draw another circle of radius 3 cm. Construct tangents to each circle from the center of other circle. So according to question, let us start the construction step by step. Okay. So, first let us draw a line segment AB of length 8 cm. So, this is a line segment of length 8 cm. Let us name this line segment as AB. Now, let us see what is the next step. Taking A as center, draw a circle of radius 4 cm. So now with A as center, we have to draw a circle of radius 4 cm. Take the compass and adjust it to 4 cm radius carefully. Now with A as center, draw the circle. Like this. Then taking B as center, draw another circle of radius 3 cm. So let us draw another circle from the point P. Take the radius 3 cm and with B as center, draw a circle. Like this. Now we have drawn the line segment AB of length 8 cm and we have also drawn a circle of radius 4 cm from the point A and we have drawn another circle of radius 3 cm from the point B. Now we have to construct tangents to each circle from the center of other circle. It means that for this circle, we have to construct the tangents from the point B. This is an external point to this circle, means first circle. From this point, we have to construct 2 tangents. And for this circle, we have to construct tangents from point A. The A point will be the external point to this circle. So from A, we get 2 tangents. So dear students, you already know how to construct the tangents from the external point to a circle. Yes, first we have to bisect the line AB and we have to find the midpoint. So let us do it. Now take the radius more than half of line AB. Then draw the arcs above the line and below the line. First, let us start from point A. Draw the arcs like this. Then from the point B, cut these previous arcs. Now, join these points of intersection of these arcs. Now, we have got the midpoint of the line AB. Let us call this point as M. Now, then with M as center, we have to draw a circle with radius equal to AM. You can see this circle is passing through the point A and B. Now I have drawn the circle with center M and radius equal to AM. Now identify where these circles are crossing. It means the points of intersection of these two circles. Let this point be P, and here is another point. You can see the two circles meet here. This is a point Q. Similarly, for this circle also, we get two points here, the points where the two circles intersect. Let this point be R, and here is another point. Let this point be S. Now join BP and BQ first. So I have joined here PB and QB. So the line PB and QB are two tangents to this circle from the point B. This is the center of another circle. So we have asked here to draw the tangents to each circle from the center of another circle. So here these are two tangents to the circle from center of another circle. I hope you understand this. Now similarly, we want the tangents to this circle from center of this circle. For this we have to join AR and AS. This is AR and this is AS. Now we got another two tangents to this circle from the point A. This is the center of another circle. So AR and AS are two tangents to this circle from center of another circle. So now we have constructed four tangents: BP, BQ, AR, AS. These are required tangents to the circles from center of other circle respectively. Now we have completed the construction. Let us justify this. For this we have to join AP and BR. Join AP and BR. So dear students, observe the circle with center M. Here AB is the diameter. This diameter is dividing the circles in two parts. We call them as semicircles. You know that angle subtended by this diameter on the semicircle will be equal to right angle. It means that the angle APB equal to 90 degree, and similarly ARB is equal to 90 degree. Because both the angles are in the semicircle. So angles in the semicircles are equal to right angle. So if these two angles are in semicircle, then we can write angle APB equal to 90 degree and ARB equal to 90 degree. If this angle is equal to 90 degree, then we can write AP is perpendicular to PB. So AP is perpendicular to PB. Similarly, this angle is also 90 degree. So what we can write? BR is perpendicular to AR. But we know that this AP and BP are radius. So a line perpendicular to end of the radius on the circle must be a tangent to a circle. So here PB is a tangent. So here also AR is a line which is perpendicular to end of the radius on the circle. This also must be a tangent to a circle. So what we can say, if AP and BR are radius of circle, then PB and AR must be tangent to a circle. Similarly, AS and BQ is also a tangent to these circles. So dear students, this is the required construction for fifth problem, and this is our justification. Hope you have understood this construction. In our next video, let us solve sixth problem from the same exercise. Till then, you have to practice these all constructions and make yourself perfect for exam. If you have any doubts, please write the comment in the comment box below the video. So thanks for watching the video. Stay healthy. Goodbye.